one of the first studies to look at how things related to the person who communicates a message might influence us was conducted by Hovland and Weiss in 1951. It's not really that surprising that we would assume that people high in credibility would be more persuasive compared to communicators who are lower in credibility. This seems like common sense, and it's probably why advertisers often have actors wearing white lab coats and safety glasses talk about the benefits of particular moisturisers and other beauty products. They try to make the actor look like a scientist because that seems more credible. To test this idea, Hovland and Weiss asked participants to read an article about the practicality of building a nuclear-powered submarine. Now, keep in mind that at this point in time, which was the early 1950s, no such submarines existed. In fact, while construction of the first nuclear-powered submarine was coincidentally authorised in 1951, the USS Nautilus, it did not set out to sea until early in 1955. Hovland and Weiss told half of their participants that this message came from a source high in credibility. Robert Oppenheimer, a famous and respected physicist who had been involved in the development of the atomic bomb. He was sometimes called the father of the atomic bomb because he led the effort at the Los Alamos laboratory. The other half of the participants were told that the message came from the Soviet newspaper Pravda, which to the American research participants would have been a source that was low in credibility. To measure how much participants were persuaded by the message, they were asked to say how practical it was to build a nuclear-powered submarine. After waiting 4 weeks, Hovland and Weiss got back in touch with the participants and asked them a second time how practical it was to build a nuclear-powered submarine. So, what do you think they found? Which communicator was more persuasive at each time?